Okay, this is going to be the wrap segment. So we've already prepped our band. My primer's on here, ready to go. When you get your wrap from us, depending on the design you have, if it's a solid pattern, you'll have it all in one piece. But a lot of the bands have different elements. There's an element, this one, for example, has a bow and a name that's gonna need to be centered on the back. And there is a lace feature on the front. And we're gonna want both of those to be centered. So when you order a design like that, I print what I consider critical elements, which are pieces that need to be centered or placed in a specific spot. I only print one of those critical elements on your actual wrap because, you know, these are custom made and they're all a little bit different, especially with the sizing, and it would be really frustrating to put a wrap on and one of the sides not be centered. So in this case, we can just focus on centering the back and then at the end, come back and put our critical element on the front. Depending on the design, like the aviator bands, they might have six pieces, I think. You know, you have the glasses and the side straps and whatnot. So you might have to put a few elements on over the wrap itself, and that's just because they're custom, and so your wrap's gonna be custom as well. This vinyl is a vinyl that is made for low energy plastics like your band. So this is gonna stick really well in comparison to a standard wrap vinyl. I've done quite a bit of testing and this is what I feel really works best and cuts down on your installation time as well because it sticks really well. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and get started. You're gonna start on whichever side your critical element is. Like I said, this is the back, so I'm gonna be starting my wrap on the back. If your wrap comes with the print on the front, then go ahead and start on the front. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna rip just some of your backer off. Do not take the whole backer off. That will make this really difficult. And then go ahead and figure out how you wanna place it. Make sure your band's centered, it's straight. If you are not happy with this placement, not a big deal. You can pick your wrap up and put it back down as many times as you need to. It is not going to damage the adhesive. It's not gonna ruin your wrap. This is very flexible. Pretty much the only way you're gonna ruin this wrap is if you cut it in the wrong spot. You can pretty much always get this to go back to the original form that you, if you need it to, okay? I am pretty happy with that placement. Looks pretty centered, pretty straight. So I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna rip just a little bit more off and I'm gonna heat this section. I have a heat gun here that I'm gonna use. If you use a heat gun, that's wonderful. I think that's gonna be the easiest thing to use, but use it on the lowest heat setting and try to always heat away from the band. Remember that your band is made of plastic and it is literally molded with heat. So if you overheat this, you can definitely distort the shape of the band, even ruin the band. So lowest heat setting, away from the band. I usually try to keep my hand behind where I'm heating because if my hand can tolerate the heat, then the band should be okay. I only heat on the band when absolutely necessary and I do it for small periods of time. If you have a blow dryer, that regular heat setting on that should be fine. So you're gonna heat it, and while you're doing that, you'll notice that there forms a little bit of wave in the material, and that's it loosening up and losing its shape a little bit, and that's gonna allow you to mold it around the shape of the band, okay? You're gonna pull just a little bit. And what's important here is that we get the center laid nicely. We can work on the top and we can work on the bottom separately, but we want that center to be nice and flat with no wrinkles, no creases. If it is wrinkled, pull it back up, reheat it, it'll go back to its original shape. I'll actually show you that right here. So let's say you lay it and you got some wrinkles. Not a huge deal. Pick it up, gonna reheat it. Starts to get that little wave there. Okay, so I got my center spot laid nice and flat here. Now right here is the start of my Velcro. So to give myself a little bit more flexibility with these two parts, I'm actually gonna cut a little spot away. I'm gonna go ahead and get this piece laid. Again, I'm heating away from the band. I got my hand behind it. A nice little wave to it. I'm actually gonna show you what overstretching does. All right. I don't know if you can see that on the camera well, but basically I've overstretched it and now I have some discoloration. Right here, I've pulled some of the color basically out of the material. But the awesome thing about this material is I'm gonna pull it back and heat it. And it's gonna go back to its original shape and the color's gonna come right back to it. You can see now, color's all uniform. I'm gonna let that cool down because now it's so hot. If I stretch it again, it's just gonna discolor again. So just letting that cool down real quick. Stretch it nice and evenly. You're gonna have some significant pull that you wanna give it. Right here I got some wrinkles coming in, some creasing. I'm gonna just give it a little bit of heat. Now this vinyl is sticking so well to these spots right here where I've stretched it, mostly because of the primer. If you're not using the primer, you might have a little bit of pullback. It might come up just a little bit, which we're going to seal this as our last step. But that could be an issue when you don't use the primer. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and we're going to wrap the rest of the band and then I'll come back and deal with the back. I'm going to rip off a little bit more backer. Keep that up. My ear hole is right, where's my ear hole? Right here. I'm gonna cut a slot in there. We're gonna need to do that to work on the back. I like to cut excess material away as I go just because it's less in my way. It makes it easier and quicker. You don't have to cut till the very end if you don't want. All right, I'm on the front here. I'm gonna go ahead and take the rest of the backer off. I got that crease, so I'm gonna pull it up to that spot. Worry about this a little bit later. I'm going to cut just a little bit out of the way. Gives me more mobility to do the top and the bottom, but you don't want it to go too close to the ends yet because most likely this is not in the correct spot. This is what happens when you don't cut off the excess. I didn't cut it off the back, so now they're sticking together. So I'm going to cut that off back here. Hands behind it, kind of blocking it from the plastic. Back and finish up the back. This is going to be the part that we stretch the most, the bottom back. It's easiest once you have your ear cut and this spot in the Velcro cut, you can lift both corners up. What's most important is we're going to get that center laid and then we're going to work on the corners. Basically, anytime you lay any kind of vinyl, you're always working from the center out. Center's nice and flat. I'm gonna lift my corner it. It's gonna get the most pull, the most stretch. Around my quarter knot. I do have a little crease right here, but we're trimming on the inside, so that's going to get trimmed right off. So I'm not going to bother pulling it up to fix that one. I'm going to do this corner. I do have a crease right there, so I'm going to lift that while I'm here. It's sticking really good. All right, and I'm around that corner. Around the Velcro feels pretty smooth. All right, and that is pretty much it for wrap. If you go ahead and come back to the next video, we're gonna do the trim process.